Let me just check this is on.
Cool, we good.
What do you want? Hey guys, what's up? I hope you've been doing well at home. So here's the thing. So a few months ago, I shared our financial testimony on YouTube. If you haven't seen that yet, I would recommend watching it. I will link it below and maybe up here somewhere if you want to watch that. I wanted to post another financial breakthrough video for you guys. Obviously, right now, everybody is really affected in their finances because of what's going on in the world and the coronavirus. As some of you may know, Chris and I take our finances very seriously when it comes to prayer. It's not something that we do on our own without God's help. We're very intentional about praying over our finances and expecting breakthrough in what's going on in our lives and what's going on in our bank account. So obviously on the news and man's opinion about what's happening with the economy is that it's going to be terrible for the next few years, that it's going to take a long time to get out of this whole thing. I respect their opinions, and I understand that there's a lot of well-educated people out there that are sharing their opinions on the economy. My personal opinion and the way that I live my life is that I get God's opinion first, and I filter out man's opinion because God is good. He's not worried. He is not stressed out. This is not taking him by surprise as much as it took everyone in the world by surprise. God is not surprised at all. So I really think it's important to get God's opinion just as much as it is to keep yourself informed by what's going on in the news, but definitely take man's opinion with a grain of salt. So I just wanted to share some thoughts that I've been having and some things that I've been talking to God about that have been really encouraging for me. Bible story, classic Bible story, Egypt, Exodus, Moses, Israelite, the Exodus story. It's a great story. We all know how it goes, unless you don't. This has been on my mind a lot. I'm gonna read it right now. Then the Lord said to Moses, I will strike Pharaoh in the land of Egypt with one more blow. After that, Pharaoh will let you leave this country. In fact, he will be so eager to get rid of you that he will force you all to leave. Tell all the Israelite men and women to ask their Egyptian neighbors for articles of silver and gold. That's Exodus 11, 1 through 3. And then if you move forward a chapter or two, and the people of Israel did as Moses had instructed. They asked the Egyptians for clothing and articles of silver and gold. The Lord caused the Egyptians to look favorably on the Israelites. They gave the Israelites whatever they asked for. So they stripped the Egyptians of their wealth. Exodus 12, 35 through 36. So this story is really profound to me because I honestly feel like this is what's happening in the spirit. The enemy is trying to rob finances. He's trying to rob your hope. He's trying to rob your future. That he's set up a global pandemic to try to steal, kill, and destroy in people's lives. God does not steal, kill, and destroy, and this virus is stealing, killing, and destroying from everybody. And just like in the story with the Israelites, how they commanded the Egyptians to give them their wealth, I really believe that God wants us to command the enemy to give back the wealth and the finances and the job and the businesses that he's tried to rob from us. So this is what I've been doing for my life. This is what I've been doing for my business. I've lost a lot of clients recently because of the coronavirus and them not being able to open their businesses up and not needing my services with social media. So this is super relevant for me, and I've been declaring more wealth than I've had before, more breakthrough than I've had before, more finances than I've had before, and I honestly believe that God is saying amen to those declarations. Just like the Israelites, they were enslaved in Egypt for 400 years. They had built wealth for the Egyptians that entire time, and in a matter of a day of them commanding the wealth be given to them, all of that money was given back to them. In one day, they got to take all of that with them. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. We receive it, Lord. And I just believe that God's gonna do that in your life. God's gonna give us repayment for all that the locusts have stolen, for all that has been robbed. And if you're believing right now that your business has been stolen from you, that your breakthrough, that your wealth, that your blessings have been taken, that you're never gonna have what you had before, that you're gonna be doomed the rest of your life to be poor, to be in lack, I just break that belief from off of your mind. That's not what's gonna happen. That's not what God's gonna do for you. Whatever was taken from you, God's gonna put back in your hands. If you belong to God, that word is for you. You have power over all the power of the enemy. You don't have to live in lack. You don't have to live being tossed to and fro by what's happening in the world. And I just wanna encourage you to take back what the enemy's tried to steal from you. Just draw a line in the sand and say, like, no, you can't have my money. You can't have my job. You can't have my career. I'm gonna do things better than I ever did them before. I'm going to excel more than I ever excelled before. before. I'm going to have more wealth than I've ever had before. I've been speaking this over my life, and I honestly know that this is gonna come because it's come before. Last time Chris and I majorly warred for our finances, and in that financial testimony video I was talking about earlier, we had to war for our finances, and God brought breakthrough that was overnight, and it changed our financial situation. Chris and I have not been agreeing with lack in our finances. We've been declaring the opposite. We've been declaring that we will have more than we've had before, that we'll have more wisdom with the money that we receive than we've ever had before, that we'll have more clients than we've had before, and we've honestly had more people coming to us to ask us to help them with their business. God is faithful. He is 100% blessing us right now, and we have not been worried about our finances. Chris's salary was cut in half. I lost my salary, and we've had more than enough money to live. We're not scraping by at all. God is still providing for us. He's still giving us breakthrough, and we know that this is just the tip of the iceberg when it comes to how much more is going to be flowing into our lives. We're setting ourselves up to receive wealth and to receive more business than we've had before the coronavirus, to receive more money monthly than before the coronavirus. We're expecting our salaries to increase. We're expecting just more blessings in general than we had before, because we will not accept the enemy trying to rob from us, and we're commanding him to pay us back with interest for any stress, any tears, any worry, anything that he took from us, any opportunities that have been taken. We're just declaring better clients, better breakthrough, better job opportunities, more money than we had before all of this happened. And I honestly want to encourage you to really be careful about what you're speaking over your finances right now. If you're aligning your beliefs and your thoughts with what the enemy wants, or what man is speaking, or what the world is saying about how bad things are going to be, you need to get that stuff out of your soul. You need to stop searching out doom and gloom messages. You need to search out what God wants, and you need to search out joy and a hope for a future. That's what we have. God's given us a hope for a future, and I am not receiving anything that does not line up with the hope for the future that I know is mine. If you want the enemy to stop having access to your finances and stop having access to your life, stop being able to steal from you, then you need to stop allowing him to have an influence in your life with your words. Your words are what's opening the door to either blessings from God or attacks from the enemy. So if you have been declaring negative things over your life because of what's been going on, I understand that it's been hard, that it's hard to not say that, like, we're upset, that we're sad, that we're depressed, that we're lonely, that we're anxious, that we lost our job, that we don't have any money. Like, I understand those are all facts, but you need to declare the truth, and the truth is that I will be blessed, I will have wealth, I will have breakthrough, I will have an amazing job. I declare better things are coming for me now than I had before. I declare more wealth in my bank account. I declare checks in the mail. So I just want to help you guys right now. If you have a hard time knowing what to pray, or if you have never done this before, I wrote out a prayer that I want to speak over you guys, that I want you to say back with me. I'm going to put it up on the screen so that you can say it along with me. We're going to kick the enemy out of our finances. We're going to kick him out of our thoughts, out of our expectations. Follow along with me. We're going to pray this together. Let's just kick the enemy out of our bank accounts. I'm going to link this prayer below so that you guys can have it. You can download it or print it out, whatever you want to do. Okay, so let's do this. Let's go. Let's get our finances back. Let's get our blessings back. We want finances. We want breakthrough. Money in the bank, God. Money in the bank. I repent of all words of lack, hopelessness, fear, and unbelief that I've declared over myself, my life, my bank account, my business, and my future. I repent of agreeing with the enemy's plans over my life. I choose right now to draw a line in the sand and declare the will of God over my finances, my career, my industry, my bank account, my wealth, my business, and my future. I renounce the agreements I've made with coronavirus or any other tool of the enemy about my finances and my future. I renounce the enemy's access to every area of my life, and I choose to believe what Jesus said, that he came to bring life and life more abundantly. I receive this and declare this over my finances, business, career, bank account, and future. I recognize that God is the owner of all wealth in the world, and I am asking and believing him for repayment with interest of anything the enemy ever stole or tried to take from me. I declare I am not limited to the natural economy or man's expectations, but I choose to participate with heaven's economy, where there are more than enough opportunities, finances, resources, relationships, ideas, and creativity. I ask for and receive fresh vision from heaven. I ask for uncommon favor in my finances, uncommon breakthrough, supernatural opportunities, checks in the mail, money found, better and more than I had before, more wealth and wisdom in my wealth than ever before. God, I want my wealth to be used by you. I want to be your treasure chest on the earth, and I ask you to purify my heart and give me financial wisdom, discernment, and breakthrough so that I can be trusted with even more wealth to create heaven culture on this earth. I declare breakthrough of resources in heaven's economy over my life and family. My occupation and workplace, my industry, my street, my neighborhood, my business, and my city. I declare these words will not fall to the ground, but accomplish what they were sent out to accomplish. I speak the blood of Jesus over every sphere of my life and all that is mine. I forbid the enemy from touching it and invite heaven in instead. Everything I need to see my destiny fulfilled has already been provided by the finished work of the cross. I declare that is unlocked to me now in the name of Jesus. Amen. God is not offended by wealth, otherwise the streets in heaven would not be paved with gold. He is not worried about his kids having money. He's not offended by money. If you use money wrong, if you're addicted to money or to spending money, that's a separate problem. You need to deal with that. But God is not offended by his kids having money or being blessed. Jesus came to bring life and to bring life more abundantly. We live our lives every day knowing that and declaring that and expecting that. What a man declares and decrees will be established unto him. That goes for the good stuff and it goes for the bad stuff. Okay, you guys, that's what I got. That's what I'm living from right now. That's what I'm expecting. I will make a follow-up video when those blessings come in, when the more comes in, because I know it's gonna come in. I am praying and expecting and believing that he's gonna do this in your guys' life too. Tell us what your situation is in the comments below, and when you see God move, write that in the comments below too, because I wanna know. I stay in touch with you guys through the comments. I really love everything that you've been saying. Take authority over your finances. You don't have to put up with lack. You don't have to put up with fear. I'm truly believing that we're gonna come out of this better than we were before. The economy is not gonna take years to come back. God has power over all the power of the enemy, and one person's prayer changes things. So pray for the economy. Pray for America to come back stronger than it ever was before. For all the other countries that need to come back stronger than they ever were before. We can transform and change what's going on in this earth. So I just declare that over all you guys. I pray for your finances right now. I believe that you will see breakthrough. God, chase them down with the wealth of heaven. And we also just thank you, God, for all the wealth that you have given us. We thank you for how you're upholding our lives. If we even have a phone or a computer to watch this video with right now, God, we thank you for that. That alone is amazing wealth. And we praise you for all that you've done in our lives so far. Thank you, God, for all that you're going to do. Amen. Okay, that's all, you guys. Thanks for tuning in. Love ya. Yeah, that's what's up.
Jesus! Jesus!